Hi, I'm Zach Spader with Cornerstone Solutions, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a simple referral tracking program within your CRM. Let's take a look. Okay, we're in our demo CRM account here. So every company tracks referrals a little bit differently. Some companies, they tie referrals to a particular company who is sending them referrals, and some companies, they have individuals that send them referrals. And so the setup may be a little bit different depending on how exactly your company tracks these. But the methods that I'm going to show you will work in either scenario. It's just you might tie the lookup fields to a different module, but it will work in either scenario. So in most companies, you start with the leads, and then the leads get converted into accounts, contacts, and deals. And so you want to track the referrals starting in the lead module, and then you want to track them once they get converted into accounts, deals, and so far on. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into setup, and we're going to go to modules and fields, and we're going to start in the leads module. Now I'm going to, for our purposes this morning, I'm just going to show you in the standard module how to set this up. And so I'm going to go into my standard leads layout. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tie the lookup field to the referral to the lead source. And so in my lead source field here, I have an option for a customer referral. So in our scenario today, we're going to tie referrals to a particular person, like a contact record in the CRM, so that we could pay out referral bonuses based on a contact record. Now, your company may do this differently. You may tie records to an account record. So maybe any record that's referred over by a particular account of yours. But the methodology that we're going to use is the same. So, but I'm going to base it on this customer referral. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to create a lookup field, and I'm going to drag it right underneath the lead source, because the only place that I want, or the only time that I want to track the referrals, is when the lead source is the customer referral. So this lookup field is going to look up to the contacts module, and we're going to call this field referral contact. Okay, and then the related list title, this is in the contacts module, what the related list title is going to be. And so in this particular case, this is going to be referred leads. So on a contact record, we'll be able to see a list of the leads that a particular person has referred. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and save this. I'll go ahead and save this record, and then again, like I said, I only want to show this referral contact lookup when the lead source is customer referral. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to back up here, and I'm going to create a layout rule. And the layout rule, we're just going to call this customer referral. And it's going to be based on the lead source field. And so we're going to say lead source is, and then we're going to choose customer referral. And so when the lead source is customer referral, we want to trigger an action. We want to show fields. Referral contact. And let's also make that mandatory as well. So when they select customer referral for a lead source, they have to enter in the referral contact. Okay, so if we have a sample record here, and let's say that this is customer referral. When I save this, yep. See, now the referral contact pops up here, and it makes me select a referral contact. And so I can go into the contact record here, since this is tied to the contact record, and I can select a contact that this person was referred by. Okay. Now in the contact record, this is going to show up as a related list down at the bottom here. And so I can see when I'm looking at a contact record, these are the leads that this person has referred. But of course, those leads are going to get converted into accounts, contacts, and deals. I also want to track that there. So I need to add these referral contact lookups on those modules as well. So we're going to go back to customization here, modules and fields. Typically, I want to track this from both a account and a deal record. I want to see the accounts that somebody has referred over and then the deals, the individual deals, because there may be more than one deal for each account. You want to track each individual deal that's associated with the record as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with accounts. We'll just go in here to accounts. We'll go back to the standard layout here. And the first thing I want to do is make sure that there's a lead source field on this record. I don't see it right off the bat. It doesn't look like there is a lead source field on this record. To shorten this video today, I'm just going to show, typically you would have the lead source pick list on this record, but for our video today, to shorten it up, I'm just going to add the referral contact lookup into this so that we can track that. And so what I'll do is I'll drag it down to the record details in the bottom here. Okay, now in this one, I want to look up to the contacts module again. And this, again, we're deciding what the related list is going to be called. And so in the contacts module now, these are going to be referred accounts. Or let's call it referral accounts to keep it the same. Okay. So we'll save that. And then we're going to do the same thing in the deals module. The deals module does have a lead source in it already. So we'll just add the lookup field right underneath the lead source like we did before. And again, referral contact. And then we're going to choose the contact module for the lookup. And then the related list tile. This again is going to show in the contacts module. So this would be referral deals. Okay. So go ahead and save that. Now, we also have to map the referral contact in the leads module to the account in the contact record. So let's exit out of here. Let's go back to the leads. And I'm going to go into my lead conversion mapping here. So I'm going to find my referral contact field. I created one for the account and one for the deal record. So I need to make sure that these are both mapped. And now when we convert that lead over, whoever the referral contact was will carry over into the account and the deal records going forward. So we had this lead here that we entered the customer referral onto. And now, if we were to convert this, actually, let's, before we convert this, let's enter a company name in here. Okay, so it's going to create a new account, a new contact. Let's create a new deal as well. Okay, so here's our account record. We'll open that up, our deal record. So in the account module here, we can look down at the bottom of the record and we can see that the referral contact carried over here. And then in the deal record, same thing. We can see the lead source, customer referral, and the referral contact both carried over into these additional records here. So now again, if I go to John Doe and I'm looking at this record, you can see that I have three related lists, the referral leads, referral accounts, and referral deals. And the referral leads that was there is no longer showing any records because the lead we had was converted. And so that's now an account and a deal. So that's now showing, okay, these are the accounts that the person has referred over. And then these are all the deals that are associated with this person as well. Okay, so that is working correctly. The last thing I want to show you real quickly is creating a report for the referral deals. And so a lot of people pay out some kind of commission on referrals. And so they would want to pay off some kind of, a bonus or something like that to the people that have referred over. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a report based on the deal module. So we're going to select the deal as the primary. Okay, and then we're also going to select the referral contact as a secondary module here, because we want to see the information from the referral contacts in here as well. So what we'll do here is we'll continue. And in this case, what I'm going to do, so the referral contact is over here. I don't need city. I don't need campaign source. The amount is nice. We have the account and deal name, so that's fine. What I want to do though is I want to filter it so it's only showing me the records that have a referral contact here. So I'm going to put a filter in the system, and I'm going to say, so contact name referral contact is not empty. Okay, so that filters it for this one record here. And then to pay out commissions, you're probably going to want to also filter this by the referral contact. And so in the columns here, I'm going to remove the referral contact from this section here in the columns. I'm going to add it into the row groups here. So we're going to select row groups. And we'll just select contact name here. And that'll group the referrals together by the referral contact. And then the other thing that you might want to do, depending on how you pay out commissions, is you might want to also add in an aggregate column for the amount. And in that particular case, we would remove amount from the columns as well here, and we would add it as an aggregate column. And so we would say like the sum of the amount from the deal, and that would give us a total of deals here. So as we add in more records into the system here, it would aggregate them by the referral contact with all the deals that have a referral contact listed on them. It will separate them out by who referred them, and then it will give a sum for each referral contact, and then a grand total at the bottom of all the referral deals. So this is just a quick run through of how you'd set up some basic referral tracking in your system. Like I said, we did this based on a contact referring over leads that would get converted into accounts and deals. But you could also do this if you want to track the company that sends over referrals by just connecting to the account module instead. But this is just some basic reporting so that you can help track the referrals in your CRM. Hope this has been helpful. Thanks.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.